Hi, hello again. We're right down the road on the other side of the bridge. We just did a video on Indiatown. This one is on Lindley Murray. He was a famous grammarian, author of the English Grammar, was born 7th June, 1745, in a house near this point. Robert Murray, his father, owned a mill here from 1745 to 1746. That mill, as soon as this truck moves, because I don't like to put people right on film, it would be down that way. It's actually past, you can see the bridge out there, that's Route 22. It would be down just past there. There's actually an old stone building that's still there, which I wouldn't be shocked if that was part of maybe the home or something like that. I mean, I'm not sure if it was quite that old, but we are here on the other side of the creek at Harper's Tavern, and that building right there is Harper's Tavern. I decided to give a little bit more history of Harper's Tavern, and I will. The original structure was somewhere in this area. It was a log structure, and there's a public house in here somewhere. It was the first one in the area, and the man that built it was Adam Harper. And Adam Harper, one of his relatives, John Harper, built this structure, which was built in 1804. It's actually quite a cool restaurant, so if you do get in the area at some point, it's a cool place to come down through. But he had bought 300 acres in the area, and then it became Harper's Homestead and became quite a cool area. So I think we're going to go somewhere else to talk about some more of this stuff, because quite frankly, it is ridiculously loud here. Or I will go down here in the grass and we'll finish talking about Lindley Murray. Eventually, I want to get to the point where I'm able to add pictures and then just do audio over top of that. So anyways, Lindley Murray, he was born here in 1745, and they eventually, because his father was a New York merchant, was quite a successful merchant, he had decided then to move here, own a mill. Not doesn't really say why, but he did that for about a year. He sent Lindley to school in Philadelphia, a prominent school there, because he wanted Lindley to eventually go into the family business of being a merchant. And then he eventually sent for him a couple years later to come down to North Carolina, where they lived for a while until they moved back to New York City, where he put Lindley back in a prominent school in New York for business, which Lindley did not like. He did not want to pursue that. He wanted to pursue something in literary arts, whether it would be being a lawyer or with the grammar for English language, which is eventually what he was able to pursue. But he actually ran away to a boarding school in New Jersey, which father promptly found him, and they brought him back. And he made it known to his father what he wanted to do, what he felt the right path was for him. And I guess the family lawyer was there and agreed with Lindley and said, you know, it may be a good idea to allow him to pursue this because he's got a real talent for literature and for, you know, law and those types of things. So he was allowed to pursue that, and he did rather well in New York with his law practice. And at some point there, I believe it was in the 1770s, he wanted to always go back to England. He was born here in Harper's Tavern, so he was always here in the U.S., but his father had come from that, and they had been Quakers, and he wanted to check out their heritage and that type of stuff, and went back for a year, came back, built the law practice, did exceedingly well, was very lucrative, and then his health started to fail. They don't say exactly what happened, but something was going wrong, and he decided he really, with a year he had been in England, he had felt very good, so he moved out into the York region of England, and he started work on his literary works, because he thought that the way grammar was presented in schools wasn't done very well, and he felt it could be done much better. So he wrote the book English Grammar, and that was, from that point forward, was used in both English schools and American schools. And he wrote a number of other different help books through that time, until I believe it was 1820, in which he also became a minister during that period of time. And they believe he contracted, I guess they think it's some kind of polio variant, and he wasn't able to walk anymore, so he retired from being a minister, and then he resolved himself to be involved with horticulture, and he had a beautiful garden at his home until his death, I believe it was 1834, 1836. And but he's renowned across the world for his work with English grammar, with the books that he's written, and he's actually used in a number of really important books like Uncle Tom's Cabin. Harriet Beecher Stowe mentions him there. Middlemarch, he was mentioned. He's mentioned by Charles Dickens in a number of his books. Also, James Joyce with Ulysses. And I believe he also mentioned in Edgar Allan Poe's works, because Edgar Allan Poe remembered him fondly for that's how he grew up on those books. So this is Lindley Murray. This is number 3 for the Pennsylvania Historical Markers. Once again, I do apologize for how loud it is. I didn't think it was going to be this loud, but that's the marker there. And there's another marker down where his father's mill was as well. So with that, we will say goodbye, and we will see you about town.